Chooch out here riding on the King Song S20. What is this, man? I'm doing some seated riding? Yep, that's right. Some seated riding on the King Song S20, some off-roading, showing y'all a little bit of up close on it, and also taking this thing up to some high speeds on some steep mountain roads, hitting some nice corners, kind of taking it through all the terrain, even some snow in this one, guys. This is a 3,300-watt electric unicycle right here, guys. This thing is awesome. It is a fast wheel with full suspension on it. You go about 43.5 miles an hour. A lot of you probably know that, but I'm giving this thing a full test, probably harder than any test I've done on any wheel in a while, because this is just one I'm excited about. I'm genuinely having a great time with this machine, and I was looking very forward to this thing coming out. Now, it had a lot of hype behind it. This wheel had tons of hype, more so than any electric unicycle released in like 7.5 or 8 years. There's never been a single wheel that had so many people excited about it. And this thing had the look to it. It had the suspension with the coil on the back of it. It had just the design that people really, I don't know if it caught their eye. I don't know if it was from a company that was very reputable in the hobby. King Song has been a renowned brand for having safety features, not having, too many issues, and having a quality machine. But they just didn't have the power there. These wheels were never extremely powerful like the B-Goad wheels. The B-Goad wheels have always been the powerhouses, but they just didn't have the build quality behind them. So basically, the B-Goad wheels were always just like, that's what they were known for. They were known for no frills, not being the prettiest looking thing in the world, not being the best build of quality, but hey, you get something that flies. It's really fast and really powerful. If you wanted to get quality and safety and all that, then traditionally in the years past, you compromised and kind of went with King Song. The only thing is, a lot of people out there just didn't think King Song was fast enough or powerful enough, including myself, until now. This thing has completely changed my whole opinion on the brand King Song and the type of wheel they make. This is the first time they've stepped over into the high performance wheel category with any wheel. They really have never made a wheel that would go near this fast. It simply flies compared to any other King Song wheel out there. It does not even feel like a King Song wheel at all. It really doesn't. This thing rides just straight up like a Gotway wheel, like as fast as one. But the only thing is that's crazy with this, guys, is it is a total just tank on your feet, man, like in a good way. Where this thing, it will bulldoze over anything, man. I hit a jump today where I didn't see the backside of it, and the downside of the jump, guys, was literally a stair set, like a gnarly, not like a clean normal stair set. This was like a mountain, like a decorative stair set that was like at this backside of a mountain. Did not even know what was I was jumping into. Jumped into it, and like even the guy walking by, like his eyebrows, like he was just like went up on his head. It was like, holy, like, dude, how did you not bust ass right there, essentially? And it, like, dude, you can literally just tank into any obstacle on this thing, and this is suspension absorbs it. And it will blow your mind, the stuff that you're able to ride out or go over, or situations where you would just totally bust it on any other wheel. This thing has your back, man. And it will literally, like, all your job is to do is just to stay on it and not bail off of it, and you'll be golden. If you can just stay on the pegs, it's going to get over or ride out whatever it is you're facing. It seriously will. It's incredible. The type of crap this thing can go over, jump down, and like the anomalies that can just strike this thing and not throw you off kilter. It's just so sick, guys. It works so good. The suspension on this one is phenomenal because of just how beefy of a machine it is too, man. This is a heavier machine, and it's just it's a good thing, man. It rides sturdy like the Sherman does. You know how the Sturman rides? Just, I mean, it's a heavier machine, but that damn thing tracks, man. It has that power behind it, and you're just good to go. And this one does the same thing, man. It just, it rides so good. It has, I mean, everything you'd want on it. I'm getting plenty of range on it. Like, I'm not really not too afraid about the range. I have done all my traditional, you know, rides and everything like that, even farther, a lot farther than my traditional rides, and I've had no problem. I really haven't. And I think maybe for someone that's a little bit heavier weight than me, you know, you may have to take it easier and not jump quite as much as and fool around as much as if you're trying to, like, if you're trying to get a lot of range out of it. But I think for most people, you'll be able to play around on it, trail ride it, jump it, and get plenty of range, man. I think you'll probably be able to get 40 miles of range out of this. The typical person just fooling around a little bit, not just hitting jumps the entire time calculating that range, but just fooling around a little bit and then commuting a little bit, I think about 40 miles. And then I think about 35 miles on it if you're just out trail riding and jumping and climbing mountains and rock crawling it and all that. I think you can expect about 35 honest miles on it. And that's riding it hard with like a heavier rider on it, guys. I'm telling you, like, realistic, like, numbers, which you can expect. I mean, this, like, 220-pound guy, like, ripping it up and down hills and jumps and crap. You know, you can probably expect about 35 miles. But someone my size doing that same thing and still trying to commute, probably 40 miles, you know? So just being completely realistic with you on it. And the tire that comes on it, man, is perfect. You see this thing, it's just, it works good in snow. So stock, you know, you guys out in snow environments, I think it'll be perfect. Desert environments, I've already tried it there, it's great. Mud, it works good. On the concrete, it works good. So I like to see this for sure, man. They actually put a tire on here that works for a lot of different people in the world. Just putting a street tire on one of these wheels is just not the smartest thing anymore, unless it's designed to be like a street racing wheel and that's what they're going for. But I don't think a lot of people in the community want a street tire stock on their wheel anymore. It's just because the Endurocross and off-road tires, they perform really well on the street. They offer a ton of traction. Just, it's unique to the electric unicycle too. It's almost weird. If you find a good off-road tire, it traditionally works really good on the road too. Like, for instance, like that Sherman tire, it's pretty daggum good, man. It's hard to beat that knobby tire even on the road with the Sherman. Just for some reason, man, it just works good. And same with this one. I mean, I would not want to put a non-knobby tire. I know that no one really would do that because this has suspension on it and is meant to be ridden off-road, but I mean, some people might end up putting a street tire on here, but I love being able to just take it over snow and ice and mud and, I mean, really get the full effect of what this thing's meant to do. I mean, it's pretty wild what it does. It is so much fun too, man. It is a blast. A total blast. Riding over all this stuff and jumping down all this stuff, going in the snow, and I mean, it handles so well. Up in the Rocky Mountains, I rode all the way down from just your typical area, like, you know, Denver's elevation, all the way up here for probably about at about 9 to 10,000 feet right here. And then those peaks that are surrounding me, all those peaks that you see, those are about 11 to 13,000 foot peaks, and there's 14,000 foot peaks all around here. So there's 14ers in Colorado. I don't think there's any you see specifically right here, but there is one behind me called Long's Peak, which is relatively close, which is a 14,000 foot mountain. You got Mount Evans, you got Mount Elbert, you got Mount Bierstadt, you got all those right up the road from here pretty much. And this thing got up here into the mountains, guys. So that's impressive. So if you, if you live somewhere where it's flat, you really have no clue the kind of the dilemma in Colorado. There's not going to be really a time where I go ride just toward the eastern plains and just try to go out there, because there's really nothing to see. Typically it's hot, typically there's a lot of traffic, and it's just like, why the hell would you go out there when you got that beautiful mountain to ride in? So doing a range test for me is pretty hard, guys, unless I'm doing a ride, which I don't want to do, which I'm just not gonna, I'm simply just not gonna go and do some mediocre ride that I don't enjoy just to get you a range test when it's not even a realistic range test. So for all my range test, guys, it's going to be skewed because I'm going up in elevation. I literally am going to be going up in elevation, down in elevation. I'm going to be riding up, you know, hills, off-road, all that type of stuff. But I can still tell you guys that this one, it's not going to disappoint you on range. Like, if you thought you were getting a wheel that was, you know, you look at it, say 2200 watt hours, you have an idea in your head about how far that can go, and it is straight up that. The suspension on the back really doesn't affect it too much, guys, unless you literally are just jumping it and using that suspension to have fun and play and torque into different jumps and just use it in a way that you wouldn't be using another wheel that had that much watt hours. It goes plenty far enough, guys. Has plenty enough power, has plenty enough torque. Oh, and another thing, guys, you talk about with the torque, I figured out the easiest, simplest method to figure out why this thing doesn't have torque for some people, guys. It's the foot pedal placement. They literally, I don't know why no one's talked about this. You can take the pedals and slide them forward. That gives you more torque. You slide them back to the position I have them in right now, it makes riding down those rocky descents and crazy hills that you saw people riding down, like in China, where they were going down those crazy rocky hills, having them in the back position like this makes your descents really easy. And then having them pushed forward makes your acceleration and torque way higher. So I'll explain that more in the actual close-up review coming up, but that's the whole thing, and I figured it out, guys. If you move those pedals forward, the torque on this thing, the low end torque, is going to be through the roof, crazy. So that's literally it. And moving the pedals forward and back does one thing and one thing big, and it changes your torque dynamics. So farther forward, faster, crazier torque, farther back. Insanely easy to get down mountain hills and crazy, like stair sets, all that type of stuff. So, you know, if you're better at
move your pedals forward
one than the other, that's how you can change it up, which is great. It's kind of like snowboard bindings. I love that about those pedals and the position you can put them in. It is really cool. So more of that coming up in the actual tabletop review. But anyways, dudes, it's been Chooch. I'll see you dudes in the next one.